This video is sponsored by DeepRobot. Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. If you're here from the previous video, glad to see you back. I assume that you're already familiar with how the LED blinking project works. If so, let's move on to the second project, SOS Beacon or SOS Distress Signal. Let's go! For this project, we don't necessarily need to change anything hardware related because the code doesn't require us to do so. I just changed the LED from yellow to red because I wanted to. Alright, let's copy and paste the sample code from the PDF to the Arduino IDE. Connect the board to the computer, make sure that we're on the correct port and using the correct board, Arduino Uno, COM9, click on verify, then upload the code. See that? The LED is blinking with an SOS pattern now. But the PDF was right. Although the code is working as intended, it is indeed a bit long. So let's use the second or more concise code that DFRobot has provided. Copy and paste it to the IDE, click on verify, and then upload the code. And there it is. As you can see here, the code does the same thing as the previous one, but it's shorter. The first and longer version of the code is just the code from the first project, but with different delay durations. The second and shorter version of the code works like this. Just like on the first project, we have added a variable called LED pin, connected it to digital pin number 10, and set it up as an output using pin mode. The first part of the two code versions are identical, but the second version uses a for statement to make the code shorter. The for statement is used to repeat a block of statements enclosed in brackets. An increment counter is usually used to increment and terminate the loop. The for loop header has three parts: initialization, condition, and increment. So for this block of code, int x equals 0 is the initialization where the value of variable x is initialized as 0. X less than 3 is the condition where x is compared and checked if it is less than 3. If the condition is valid or true, it would execute the digital write statement inside the brackets. After executing it once, it would then increment the variable x and would change it from 0 to 1. Then it would repeat the comparing process, but this time comparing the variable x, which is now 1, to 3. If the result of the condition is still valid or true, it would execute the digital write statement inside the brackets again, and would repeat the process until variable x is not valid or not less than 3 anymore. When that happens, the program would skip over the code and proceed on to the next part of the sketch. We set the condition x less than 3 to repeat 3 times, calculating and comparing from 0 to 2, or 0, 1, 2. That's it! For a more in-depth explanation, please refer to the PDF. Click right here if you feel ready to move on to the next project. See ya!